Hi, I'm Li Mingjiang. I'll present our paper, Focal Frequency Loss for Image Reconstruction and Synthesis. Despite the remarkable success in image reconstruction and synthesis, gaps could still exist between the real and generated images. Through the spectral analysis, we show that gaps in the frequency domain may be a common issue for typical generative models. Previous studies suggest that the gaps are due to the inherent bias of neural networks towards low-frequency functions, for example, spectral bias and F principle. By performing standard band-limiting operations, we simulate the effects of missing frequencies and observe that the losses of different regions on the spectrum correspond to different artifacts on the image. We deduce that compensating for these losses may reduce artifacts and ameliorate image quality further. In this study, we propose focal frequency loss that is complementary to existing spatial losses. It is formulated in three steps. First, we explicitly transform both the real and generated images to their frequency representations by standard discrete Fourier transform, facilitating optimization in the frequency dimension. We then define a frequency distance to quantify the differences between images in the frequency domain. We rewrite the frequency representation FUV into A plus BI. Here are two key elements in FUV. The first one is amplitude. It manifests the energy, how strongly an image responds to the 2D sine wave with a specific frequency. The second one is phase. It represents the shift of a 2D sine wave from the wave at the beginning of a cycle. A frequency distance should consider both amplitude and phase. Through a simple single image reconstruction experiment, we show that a phase-flow reconstruction can only be achieved by considering both amplitude and phase information. Our solution is to map each frequency value to a Euclidean vector in a two-dimensional space. The vector magnitude and angle correspond to the amplitude and phase, respectively. Thus, the frequency distance corresponds to the distance between two vectors. We simply apply the squared Euclidean distance. The final step is called dynamic spectrum weighting. To cope with the frequency components that are hard to synthesize, we focus the model training on them. We introduce a spectrum weight matrix to downweight easy frequencies. The matrix is dynamically determined by a non-uniform distribution on the current loss of each frequency during training, where alpha here is the scaling factor for the flexibility. By performing the Hadamard product for the spectrum weight matrix and the frequency distance matrix, we have the full form of FFL. In addition, we know that the exact form of FFL is not crucial and also provides some loss variance. For a more intuitive illustration, we can regard the frequency representation as a new dimension of an image. Focusing on the hard frequencies can be seen as an optimization in the H dimension here, while pixel dimensions correspond to L and W. That's why FFL complements spatial losses. Here are results of image reconstruction and unconditional synthesis on autoencoders. FFL helps generate high frequency details and improves quality. As an example, gaps in the frequency domain are clearly narrowed by FFL for VAE reconstruction on setup A. For conditional synthesis, we examine two typical GAN-based image-to-image translation methods, pixel-to-pixel and SPADE. FFL improves image quality by reducing unnatural artifacts and generating essential details. We further study the potential of FFL on state-of-the-art StyleGAN 2. It reduces tiny artifacts and evidently mitigates the frequency domain gaps between mini-batch and rich spectra. Here are two high-resolution examples synthesized by StyleGAN 2 with FFL, which are pretty photorealistic. Finally, we present some quantitative results. The evaluation metrics can be boosted by FFL in nearly all cases. For more details, please refer to our paper. Our code has been made publicly available, and you can directly install focal frequency loss through PIP. Thank you for watching.